identify and connect to provide a generic dashboard, a generic skeleton that can be associated to match specific contents, context in specific user needs, etc. So the methodology, as I said before, we use meta-modeling. We study the dashboard domain, we see different dashboards, and we abstract the different structure present in the domain, the different relationship or properties, to obtain a meta-model that in the end we could transform into more concrete models that match the different dashboards. We also use domain engineer, which is very related to this meta-modeling approach, because we study the domain and we seek for different commonalities and variability points among the dashboard to end up with a domain implementation with different core assets that can be parameterized into concrete components. So the meta model has three parts: the user, the layout, and the components. Why is it so important to include the user in this meta model? Because users are the drivers of the dashboard design. They are the consumers of the information, so we need to take into account their goals and their characteristics in order to deliver an effective dashboard. For example, we attend to different goals that the user could have regarding the information, and this goal should be decomposing to different tasks that need to be supported by the different components of the dashboard. And also the user characteristics. For example, preferences, disabilities, the knowledge about the domain, because some users could need more contextual information because they are not expert in the domain. Also the literacy regarding visualization. Some users could understand perfectly a bar chart, but other kind of charts are more complex for them to understand. And also bias. The layout is simple. We decompose the dashboard into different pages composed of different containers that could be also contained in another container. And these containers could be rows or columns. And this is the main part of the meta model, which is where we decompose the what could be the components of the dashboard. For example, we could have different controls, graphic resources, text, for example, to give contextual information, but the main components in the end of dashboards are visualizations. So we try to abstract the different features that a visualization could have. For example, a visualization could be composed of different axes, different marks, visual marks, and annotation. Marks are the elements that represent the different variables. For example, in a bar chart, the bar will represent some kind of data. Marks could be tensor links, for example, to differentiate between individual marks or connections among variables. And also the most important part is that marks are encoded through different channels. For example, a mark could encode a variable through the size, through the position, through the color, and these are guided by different scales. So I'm going to show you a very small example of an instantiation. In this case, it's an application of the meta model to learning analytics to show that it could be useful in different domains. So in this case, we instantiated a network graph, which in this case is very simple, but its circle will represent a student who is positioned based on the number of interactions with other students, for example, to analyze the interaction in a MOOC or any other platform. So students that interact a lot with each other would be closer, and students that don't interact at all would be isolated. So in this meta model, the instantiation would be this way. The network graph would be an instance of a visualization, and it would be composed of connectors and circles, which are related. Then the circle is a position regarding some scale that is based on the count of interactions between students. That would be part of a theoretical student data set that we could have. So, this meta-modeling approach is applicable to the dashboard domain, and given its complexity, is very useful. Users are and must be the drivers of dashboard because they are an unquestionable part of the design process. Representing the channels also is crucial. That is why the channel meta class is present in the meta model, because several studies reflect the relevance of choosing an appropriate encoding in a specific context in order to enhance this perception of data. Also, of course, access and scale are also necessary to ensure the proper representation. And we also decided to include other resources like labels, legends, and annotations because they have a very important role in the contextualization of information. The purpose of having this meta-model is not only to understand such a complex domain, but also to develop this artifact that can be, in the end, instantiated into concrete dashboard. So the main focus of the research is to use this meta-model to generate final products, functional, etc. And this would be useful to create this generation pipeline. In order to, we will have the different instantiation of this meta-model, and the goal is to obtain from this a functional product. So the dashboard domain have been studied to extract these features, these abstract features. The identified elements have been arranged in this meta model that can be instantiated, and of course the feature reserve line will involve their refinement, continuous refinement of the meta model through the addition of constraints and even design guidelines to obtain well-designed dashboards. And also, of course, the meta-model must be validated through different and more complete case studies. So, thank you very much.